Hey guys, happy Monday. It is Monday, April 6th, and I'm really looking forward to bringing you another week of classes. I miss you. I so wish I could be there with you, but this is a great way for us to connect. And thank you for the feedback about classes last week, and I'm looking forward to bringing you another week of classes. Now, you may wonder why I'm all dressed up like this. Well, I am bringing a new series, what I like to call Oscar Trivia Day. And Oscar Trivia Day, we're going to learn a little bit about movie history through these Oscar Trivia questions. So this will be a series, so I'll be doing more of these about our time that we're alone, together, alone but together, right? That we're connecting through these video classes. So what I would like you to do is go see if you get a piece of paper, any type of paper and a pen. So I'll wait. Good. All right, guys. So what I want you to do now that you have your paper and pen, number 1 through 5, or and a writing note that is more challenging for you. Then you can always say the answers out loud. But if you're able and get a piece of paper and number 1 through 5. Cool. Alright. Good. Now how this work is, I'm going to ask you a question and then you write down the answer on your piece of paper. So let me give you a non-Oscar example. Say I asked, what year did Performing Arts Studio West produce their multimedia show, The Alternative? Was it 2016, 2017, 2018, or 2019? What year did Performing Arts Studio West produce the multimedia show The Alternative? Was it 2016, 2017, 2018, or 2019? Okay. So, the answer is 2019. So you would just write down the answer right there, right? 2019, like that. So again, I'm going to ask you some Oscar questions, and you write down the answer, and we'll see if you're right. Okay. So our first Oscar question is: in 1973, Tatum O'Neal became the youngest actress to ever win a Best Supporting Actress Award. She became the youngest actress to ever win a Best Supporting Actress Award for her role in A Paper Moon. That was in 1973. How old was Tatum O'Neal when she won? Was she 8? Was she 7? Was she 10? Or was she 12? In 1973, the actress Tatum O'Neal became the youngest actress to ever win a Best Supporting Actress nomination. Nomination and award. She won for that. How old was she when she won? Was she 8? Was she 7? Was she 10? Or was she 12? And the winning answer is, well, 10. So if you get 10, you're right. If you wrote down the age 10, you're right. So when Tate Monet was 10 years old, she won the Oscar, and she is one of the youngest actresses, the youngest actress to ever win an Oscar at the age of 10. All right. Question number 2. Katharine Hepburn has won the most Oscars for Best Actress. She had the most Best Actress Oscars. How many did she have? 3, 4, 5, or 8? So how many times has Katharine Hepburn won a Best Actress Oscar? Has she won one 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, or 8 times? Write down your answer or say your answer out loud. 3, 4, 5, or 8. Okay. And the winning answer is 4. So if you guess 4, you're right. And she won in 1933 for Morning Glory, 1967 for Guess Who's Coming to Dinner, 1968 for The Lion and Winner, and 1981 for On Golden Pond. So, Katharine Hepburn has the most Best Actress Oscars. She has 4, and again, she won. And look at that, that 50-year span, almost, from 1931, that's about like 48 years, about. So she won her first one for Morning Glory in 1933. She won one for Guess Who's Coming to Dinner in 1967. She won one for the Lion in Winter in 1968. I almost said The Lion King. She did not win for The Lion King. She won for The Lion in Winter in 1968 and won for On Golden Pond in 1981. So, our third Ask a Question. The films that have won the most Oscars, the 3 that are tied. They were Ben-Hur in 1959, The Titanic in 1998, and Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King in 2003. So these 3 films, Ben-Hur, The Titanic, and Lord of the Rings, Return of the King, all have won the same amount of Oscars. How many Oscars have each of these films won? Was it 9? 11, 12, or 8? How many Oscars did the films Ben-Hur, The Titanic, and Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King win? Have they all won 9 Oscars, 11 Oscars, 12 Oscars, or 8 Oscars? Write down your answer and say it out loud. 9, 11, 12, or 8. And if you guess 11, you won. Very good. Right answer. Good. All right, 2 more questions, then we get to our bonus round. All right, Jack Nicholson is the actor who has received the most acting nominations for actor. So he has received the most. How many times has Jack Nicholson been nominated for an Oscar? Has he been nominated 15 times, 10 times, 9 times, or 12 times? How many Oscar nominations has Jack Nicholson received? 15, 10, 9, or 12? Say your answer out loud or write it down. He has received 15, 10, 9, or 12. How many times do you think Jack Nicholson has been nominated for an Oscar? 15, 10, 9, or 12? And the winning answer is 12. He has been nominated for 12 Oscars and won 3. He won in 1976 for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, which is a phenomenal movie. He won in 1998 for As Good As It Gets. And in 1984, he received the Best Supporting Oscar for Terms of Endearment. So the answer is Jack Nicholson has been nominated for 12 Oscars and won 3. He won in 98 for As Good As It Gets. That was the Best Actor. He won in 1976 for One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. The two Best Actor Oscars and the Best Supporting Actor for Terms of Endearment in 1984. Final question. Then we'll go on to the bonus. Okay. Meryl Streep has been honored with the most Best Actress nomination and as the actor, male or female, who's been nominated for, no one has been nominated for as many Oscars as Meryl Streep. She had the most Oscar nominations. How many did she have? 25, 14, 16, or 18? So again, how many times has Meryl Streep been nominated for an Oscar? Is it 25, 14, 16 or 18. Say that answer out loud or write it down. And the winning answer is 18. She's been nominated for 18 Oscars. And she's won 3. She's won 2 Best Actress Oscars for Sophie's Choice in 1983, and The Iron Lady in 2012, and she won the Best Supporting Actress in the Oscar for Kramer vs. Kramer in 1980. That was the film that put her on the map, Kramer vs. Kramer. That's when everyone was like, oh, wow, who's that? She's amazing. So again, how many Oscar nominations has Meryl Streep received 18, and she's won 3. Two best actress Oscars for Sophie's Choice in 1983 and The Iron Lady in 2012. Among Best Supporting Actress Oscar for Kramer vs. Kramer in 1980. So, how'd you do, guys? How many did you get? Email me and let me know. And I have a new email I'm going to show you too. But before that, I have a bonus question. Alright, so the bonus question is the one I want you to research on the internet yourself and then send me an email and let me know what the answer is. And the bonus question is, who was the first and only woman to win a Best Director Oscar? Who was the first and only woman to win a Best Director Oscar? Okay? So I want you to look that up and email me at my new email, djclass@gmail.com. That's djclass@gmail.com. djclass@gmail.com. And also, let me know how you did on the Oscar, on the question. How many did you get right? I'd love to know. So you can put that in the comments of 78 mil at DEJClass at gmail.com and can also put the answer to the bonus question, who was the first and only woman to win a Best Director Oscar. You can also put that in the comment section or on the Facebook page, because I'm going to post the bonus question on the Facebook page too. Well, thank you guys. I hope you enjoyed your first Oscar trivia day. I'll be back tomorrow with another class. Until then, I love you and I miss you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.